We've come to the racing stables of Uplands, which is one of the most famous stables in Lambourne. It's steeped in racing history. Many champions have been trained from here, including the likes of Fred Winters, Pendle and Crisp. And now this fellow can be added to the list. World hurdle winner Cole Harden, trained by Warren Greatrex. So how does it feel now? Has it finally sunk in, world hurdle winning trainer?
Yeah, we're getting there. Yeah, no, still pinching myself a bit, but it's been fantastic. And just everyone congratulating us, you know, it's an amazing feat and we're very proud of it. We had a plan and we knew we had to go hard and go early, and it took a little bit of extra, probably coaching to Gavin, that I really got him in the zone, that he knew, you know, this is, you know, been waiting for this for a long time, so we needed to get it right. You know, we'd seen a huge improvement. Obviously, he won at Weatherby for early in the season, and then we knew we were struggling a bit during the winter months, but, you know, people on the outside probably weren't seeing that, but, you know, he was still running well. But after he ran in the Cleve and we got his win done, he was a different horse, and he was really exciting as at home, and we'd taken him to Kempton and Newbury, and he was flying. So going in there, we knew we had him in the best form you could possibly have him.
Talk us through it, turning from home. Did you believe it was happening?
Well, at the top, three out, he got a good jump three out, and I was sort of thinking, okay, we're happy here. And then two out, he jumped well again, and I'm thinking, well, they're going to have to move now to get him. And then sort of turning in, I saw the camera shot, and you sort of thought they were coming to get him. And then the next camera shot, he was 2-3 clear, and I'm thinking, well, if we jump this, we win. And I'm thinking, right, try and be cool. And then it all went out the window because it's a dream. And, you know, there's 27 races at Cheltenham, but four big ones, and we've won a big one.
It was one of those that everything happened perfectly on the day. And, you know, he came out on top, but he must take my hat off to Warren, the team, and to Graham. He was in superb form, and that's why I was confident, because I knew he was in the form he needed to be in. I knew I had plenty left. As soon as we jumped the second last, I knew then that it was going to be, I won't say smooth sailing, but you know, I knew that I was going to pick up and gallop all the way to the line.
What are his key attributes? What makes him so special?
His attitude. I think he's got a heart the size of him. I think that's the big thing. No, he's not that flamboyant horse or anything. He goes out there, he's almost workmanlike, but you know, he's got that attitude, and I think that stands him in good stead. But he's a brilliant ride. He jumps great, does everything right, and he's a very forward going horse.
But a lot of hard work in. We've only been going three seasons on our own, and you know, we know that, you know, we can do it. And but until you're on the big stage, we believed in the horse, but you don't ever think you're going to do it, really.
Gavin's a big part of it. Obviously, he executed the perfect ride. The horse is another. But how about the person who does all the hard work at home? Because you were quick to attribute the success to Graham Baines, who's your head lad.
Yeah, Graham's been with me since I started training. He rides his horse every day. The only time that Gavin ever sits on it is to school it. And then he generally gets run away with most of the time on him. But Graham, you know, he's got a lot of experience. He's worked for some great people. And he's a very good judge at home, and he knew that we had this horse spot on, and he works very hard, and it's just deserves.
Been with Warren since he started. We've been through quite a lot. When we came here, we only had 10 horses, and it was hard work to begin with, and to where we are now, and all the work that goes behind the scenes from everyone is great. And I don't often go racing, and that's the first time I've been racing for a long time, so it was great to be there.
Tell us about Cole Harden as an individual. I think he likes to, he's often ridden on his own, isn't he? And I know he can be a bit strong.
Yeah, what you see of him on the race course is pretty much what he's like at home. He's very forward going. He just likes to get on with it. Basically just point and steer him in whatever direction he wants to go in, and he gets on with it. He's very straightforward, to be fair. He can be quite free going, but I think a lot of that is because his canters are just, because he's a good horse, his normal canter is a lot quicker than other horses, and he just likes to get on with it, and he loves his work, and the harder you are on him at home, the more he thrives on it. He doesn't like being fresh or being too easy on him. He's just an absolute grafter, and he loves his work. And he's, like you say, what you see with him on the race course is exactly what he's like at home.
I think it's just slowly starting to sink in. At the time, we just couldn't believe it. You just don't think it's ever going to happen to people like us, you know. It's, and with it being so dominated the first 2 days with Willie Mullins and the second day Paul Nicholls, you know, you just hope to be competitive, let alone win, especially a grade one, I guess. We're like a big family here. I think that's why it was so emotional, because it's sort of been a roller coaster. And, you know, we've all put so much time and effort. And, you know, we've all been at it from the beginning. We've only been going 3 years. And the guys that were all involved directly with this horse, owners included, we were all came here together not knowing whether we were going to make it or not. And so, yeah, it was a real sort of emotional moment to think, actually, maybe we have, or we can do it, you know. And I think that's what was sort of so emotional about it, really.
Tess is fantastic. You know, she buys all the horses, or pretty much all of them. Great judge of a horse. Very good rider, great horsewoman, just, you know, big asset, great help to me, because I won't be the easiest sometimes, but, you know, she's a big part of it, and it was good that, you know, she could be part of it as well.
Now in his third season since starting out on his own at Uplands with around a dozen horses, Warren now trains 80 inmates and continues to maintain a strike rate of over 20%. With 45 winners so far this season, a Cheltenham Festival win and a championship race, and nearly £500,000 in prize money, it's easy to see why some of the biggest and the most successful owners in racing are keen to have horses in his yard.
We've taken really big risk, especially our first year, and we bought quite a few stores, and not necessarily with owners, but we knew if we didn't go out and buy some stock, we'd have nothing to sell to people. And, you know, Warren really believes in the fact he can train. So if he can train them, you know, I can find him the horses type thing. And then hopefully the owners will come. And, you know, it has really paid off doing it that way. I mean, it was quite scary at the time when we were sort of carrying 10 stores. But, you know, like anything, unless you've got horses to train, you can't train winners. And building up a strong team of young horses and being able to buy better quality and pedigrees. And also the other thing is we can't really afford to buy these point-to-point winners who are making £100,000 plus. So we kind of got to go back and make them ourselves, you know, as much as we like to, and we're sort of getting there. But, you know, at the same time, we've done really well with horses that cost between 20 and 30 and, you know, a maximum of 40. And I think, you know, we can't really spend more than we can afford, and that's kind of our motto, you know, to stick within our means to a point. And, you know, there are, you know, hopefully it's working.
You bought Cole Harden in that £20,000 bracket. This fella here is another one, Mr. Approach, that you've bought, and the list could go on. I'd say you buy most of the horses here.
Yeah, no, I definitely buy a big percentage. And, you know, like I said before, we don't necessarily always have an owner when we buy these horses, but we buy what we like and we feel we could sell and we think it's got ability. And, you know, I think owners come when they buy these things, when they see that you believe in them too, you know, the fact that we've taken the risk. And, you know, it's just a format that's kind of worked for us.
You can go and have plenty of winners, but, you know, this is the best of the best. And, you know, we prove we can, you know, cope with the Hendersons and the Mullins and the Nicholls, and we, you know, we've beaten them in the biggest stage, you know, in racing. So, you know, you would like to think there'd be more people. You know, I'm very lucky anyway, in a short space of time, you know, we've got some big owners in the yard, but you never know, there might be some other people knocking on the door.
With the taste of festival success, Warren and the team are hoping to follow up in a couple of the feature races at Aintree. A couple of horses to run in the National this year, and this fella just behind us, Tranquil Sea, is a horse who he didn't quite make the cut last year, but I can see why you want to go for it, because he's got good experience over the fences.
Yeah, no, he's run over there and run well, obviously 13 now, so probably not many years left in him, but he won a nice veterans trace last year, and I've kept him as fresh as I can this year, and he ran really well at Newbury a few weeks ago. I think he'll stay the trip, no problem. You know, He's off a nice weight of 10.5, and he'll definitely go in there. He's a big price, but you know, he's experienced. He's got a lot of ability, and he deserves to take his chance. Like we all know, you need to be able to jump around there, and with these older horses as well, something a bit different. But you know, he was electric at Newbury the other day. I think years ago, you know, he wouldn't have probably got the trip, but he will get it now. And I ran him. I mean, I thought he would need the race at Newbury, and over 3-2, he was staying on strongly at the end. So, you know, he'll go there. And with these older horses, you know, the buzz and the atmosphere, it brings them alive. And he could run very well at a big price.
Dollar Tulu is a horse that he seems to be progressing. And he's a fairly cheap, modest purchase for Andrew Black.
Yeah, no, we were, Tess and I were advised by Anthony Bromley. He was actually owned by Simon Near. He'd been with Paul Nichols as a young horse, and then went back to France. And we picked him up for €4,500. He'd just been a great servant. Still not very old. He's only an 8-year-old, and his run in the Roland Merrick was probably his best yet. And you know, he really stamped himself a proper national type then. I tried him over the national fences in the Grand Sefton, and just too short a trip really.
But he jumped well. He ran well.
Yeah, he did. And Dennis O'Regan rode him, and he said he loved it. Made one little error, and that was just because he was probably going too quick. But he said after that he jumped well then and stayed on well. He was very keen to keep the ride, but unfortunately I have another couple of jockeys that are banging on the door to ride them.
We're here with Seedling Warren, and he looked to have good claims in the Supreme Novice off the back of a win at Cheltenham, and the form had worked out.
Yeah, no, I thought at a big price he could run very well. Unfortunately, we had a little slip up, but these things happen. You know, he would never have gone that fast ever, and it was just him and Gavin had a different idea of what they wanted to do. And when you're going that quick, you know, things can happen and the margins are even smaller. So he came back none the worse. He'll now go to Aintree for the 2.5 mile novice, and hopefully he can read the script better, and they can do a lot better there.
Just watching a rerun of the race. Even if the partnership had stayed intact, they always looked like they were going a little bit too quick for him. So a step up in trip, would that suit him?
Yeah, possibly. The only thing I will say, the hurdle before, he came up quite long. And I think that is what made him. So he was actually travelling okay then. And then the difference is where if he'd made that mistake on a Monday or Tuesday, it would have been a loss of length. But he actually lost probably 2 or 3. And then you're trying to chase the race. I think in hindsight, if we probably sat and suffered that we'd made that mistake, you know, Gavin then went to the next hurdle and thought he needed a big one to keep in the race. It's just one of those things. But, you know, his form was good before that. He was 3 from 3. He was progressing well. But he's come back none the worse, and he's very fresh and well. And I think he could run well at Aintree.
With the horses running well and a championship race in the bag, Warren is hoping to target the Punchestown Festival for the first time with a couple of his young horses. Warren, we're here with One Track Mind, who you're hoping to take to Punchestown.
Yeah, no, that was been the plan. He's won 2 hurdles this year. He won at Wetherby first time. Then he sort of fluffed his lines at Chepstow. He ran out at the bottom bend there. Then he went to the Challow and finished 4th, and ran a really, really good race. And then I took him back to Wetherby and he won impressively again. So I didn't think he was ready for Cheltenham. I don't think the track at Aintree will suit him that much. And I thought, well, he deserves a go at a big pot, so I thought, well, we'll leave him as late as we can to physically develop, and he'll go to Punchestown in the 3 mile novice.
Going back 2 runs ago, experts have said it's a decent Challow. It was it was quite a slowly run race, and he wasn't beaten that far. So
no, he wasn't, and I think the race before at Chepstow, if he'd run in that, I think he would have been a lot closer in the Challow. I think he needed a bit more experience, which he was quite green in the Challow still, but he ran very well and ran to the line, and you know he's going to be a chaser in a year or so's time, and he's got so much talent. He's a bit of a Jack the Lad and a bit of a baby still, but you know, in a couple of years' time when he goes over fences, you'll see him at his best. But he's got a lot of ability.
You showed he came out of Newbury fine with the win at Wetherby. He won very nicely under a penalty. So.
Yeah, no, he has got a lot of talent. He's very. Versatile, he'll go on any ground, and he's just a really nice horse to look forward to in the future.
Is he going to go up in trip then at Punchestown?
Yeah, so that'll be, so he's only run over 2.5 in the Challow, and then he went back to 2.4, but he'll get the 3 mile no problem. And especially now, you know, he'll have had a long rest between Wetherby and Punchestown, and physically he's developing every day, and he could run a big race over there.
You've really been here on your own 3 years now, and you've gone from sort of 15 or 20 horses to nearly 80. That's off the back of maintaining a very healthy strike rate.
Yeah, no, it's been fantastic, and we came here under 3 years ago. We arrived with 10, and we've worked extremely hard and done everything we can, you know, to keep progressing. We're a young team. We're very hungry. We want to be, you know, the best we can be, and it's just progressed well. And I'm very lucky. I've got a lot of people around me that, you know what they're doing, and just from season to season, it's got better. And we've got a nice horse to start with, and then it's just getting the best out of those horses, and it seems to be working.
How important is it to have a good jockey? You've got Gavin as your number one rider. He's grown with you, so to speak, because he was champion conditional here, and it looks as if you can continue to grow together.
Yeah, exactly. It's you know, we don't want to let... I think a big thing is we don't want to let each other down. So when I put him up, I give... You know, I've got complete faith in what he does, and I'd like to think the other way around. You know, he knows when I say, you know, this horse will run well, it will. So he goes out with confidence. I'm confident in him. But he's come a long way in a short space of time. He makes mistakes, but he learns from them very quickly. But he's, you know, and as you can see at Cheltenham, he's holding his own with the, you know, the best around. So he's got a very bright future. As long as he keeps his feet on the ground and keeps working, he'll be fine.
Keeps focused. He's very ambitious. I know you are too. Where would you like to be in a few years' time?
Well, you want to be the best, don't you? I mean, you know, just keep progressing. Keep the horses getting better and better. And we just want to be competing. You know, like I said last week, we won one of the biggest races of the season. And to go back there, you know, we want to go back there year in, year out and keep competing, and we'll do everything we can to do that.
I know you're a real perfectionist. You've had good training with the Duke, Oliver Sherwood. Something that I noticed you did this year was you had a sort of quieter spell. You didn't run as many horses. Was that something you're going to do each year? Because it's a long season for
people. It is. I learned this year, you know, you have to learn quickly, and because we were doing so well, I probably should have given them a break a bit earlier. I think when you have the horses in from July, and you can't keep them at peak fitness and in health the whole way through. So that'll be something I'll be looking for, you know, to do in future years. You know, maybe have a proper break just after Christmas, maybe, so that then we can continue in February and March. Because the big meetings are in the spring. You know, everyone knows that I had a quiet January, but we made sure we got it right, and thankfully we got it right quick enough so we were able to compete last week, etc. And you know, they seem in really good form now, so hopefully towards the end of the season we can have a really, you know, good end. We've got some lovely youngsters, you know, 4-year-old bumper horses to come out, so hopefully, I mean, it's going to take a bit to beat last year's record, but we'll be, you know, they're a nice bunch, and we'll be trying to win with as many as we can.
April, May was a very good time for you last year.
Yeah, it was brilliant, and the youngsters did really well. I wouldn't be excessively hard on the horses, so they came right last spring, and you know, they seem to be doing that now after giving them a break, and hopefully we can finish well.